Welcome to the project demonstration of IoT home automation along with fan controlling and with light intensity controlling system. So here we are going to control these two loads. So here one bulb intensity will be controlling from 0 to 9. So it is a 10 levels. So 0 is off and 9 is the highest level, and fan in controlling on off. So these operations will be received through the ESP8266 Wi-Fi module, and from the Blink app we are going to sending the commands. And this will be read by the PIC microcontroller. So we are using PIC 16F73 microcontroller, and is the main device which is interfacing between the input module and output modules. So for motor, DC fan on and off purpose, we are making use of one transistor. So as we know, the transistor is a switch, so which will use it to on and off the motor, and it is connected at C4 pin. And next, TRIAC is used to control the bulb intensity, and this was connected at C0 pin. And here we need to control the bulb intensity. For that we need to use a zero crossing detector also. Why? Because we are controlling the AC bulb. So when we are controlling the AC PWM signal, then we should get the zero crossing. Whenever the positive wave cycle crossing the zero, then only the microcontroller will trigger the transistor. TRIAC. So that is BT136. So here, as we know that we are using 230 volts 50 hertz of frequency. That is nothing but in 1 second we will get 50 pulses. That is on pulses 50 and off pulses 50. That is a sine waveform. So whenever the on pulse is given to the bulb, then only the bulb will get on, when it will get the full off cycle of positive off cycle. And we are going to control that positive off cycle by dividing that into 10 steps. So 0 nothing but, so total is 0, and 5 is 50% of off cycle is given to the TRIAC and it was given to the bulb. So in that way we are going to control the bulb intensity by controlling the positive off cycle. So coming to this board, so there is a one DIAC, that is MBOC3021 is a DIAC which can control the TRIAC, because the TRIAC need AC signal, then only it will be on and off. So but the microcontroller will provide the only DC trigger pulses. So we are going to convert the DC trigger pulse to AC trigger pulse with the help of this DIAC. So means microcontroller will trigger the DIAC will trigger the TRIAC will trigger the bulb. Okay, and coming to this zero crossing detector. So here we are going to provide mainly 230 volts input from the transistor, from this one, and it will take the input to the 230 volts AC to 12 volts of AC will be converted from this transformer. So the 12 volts AC given as input to this regulator power supply board parallelly to the zero crossing detector. So coming to this regulator power supply board, there are 4 diodes are connected in bridge rectifier manner. We will get 12 volts AC to 12 volts DC, and that is pulsating DC. So after this capacitor, we will get the pure DC, and after this 7805 regulator, we will get constant 5 volts regulator power supply. Once the constant 5 volts regulator power supply given to the microcontroller, it start reading input from the as usually input and output modules. And coming to this motherboard, there will be a this one is a reset switch, to just in order to restart the microcontroller. And this one is a steel plated one, is crystal oscillator, which will provide the 20 megahertz clock frequency to the microcontroller. The purpose of the crystal oscillator is, so as we have already programmed the microcontroller with set of instructions like read the input from the module and control the output modules. So these instructions are coded in embedded C language. So the microcontroller need a clock pulse, one clock pulse for one instruction. Like that we are providing 20 mega clock pulses, means microcontroller will execute 20 mega instruction lines in 1 second. So that is the fastness of our microcontroller. And coming to the zero crossing detector, so parallelly same 12 volts AC given input to the DB107. This is a bridge rectifier inbuilt. We have placed 4 diodes, so we will get pulsating DC from this. So pulsating DC nothing but positive wave cycle, the positive off cycle given as input to the transistor. So there we are using the 10 kilo ohm resistors of 2. Parallelly we are dividing the voltage, so that is a potential divider. So means dividing the voltage V1 plus V2. So 10 kilo ohm nothing but parallel will divide 6 volts and 6 volts, as we are providing 12 volts AC, and output of this one 12 volts pulsating DC. And whenever the zero crosses, then and there the transistor will get switched on, and it will inform to the microcontroller the positive off cycle is started, and then the microcontroller will trigger the TRIAC based on the input signal from the Blink app, how much of level we have set from the blink cap. Okay, so this is the purpose. And before switching on these kits, we need to install the application, blink application, there's a blink legacy application in your phone, and go to hotspot settings. After installation of the application, go to hotspot settings and change the hotspot name to Project 4795. All are small letters without any space. That's very important. And next, password should be 129. Don't miss any character, don't add any extra things, because the system will not connect to the mobile phone. And enable the hotspot along with data. And log into the Blink app with the given credentials. And now switch on the power source to the system. So initially this motor will on and off two times, indicated parallelly, bulb, LED and DC fan. And after system got connected, if the bulb is on, then restart the system. The bulb should be in zero, it should be off condition only. Right, now it is the off state. And now we can, when we controlling from one mobile phone, the same status will be appearing another mobile phone, those who log into the same credentials Blink app. So now I'm controlling that high intensity and 50%, and again 1, 2, 4, 3, 5, 7, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Again 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can observe the same is parallelly changing in another mobile phone also. Right. And also DC fan off and on. So like this we can control the home automation devices, and also we can control the dimmer circuits to dim the bulb from anywhere in the world. And only thing is, we need to provide the internet service to this ESP8266 from nearby hotspots. And anyone can access the system by just login to the Blink app with the given credentials. They can control the device.